Hello students, I welcome you to the next class of tetrasporic embryosacs. So we started the study of tetrasporic embryosacs. In that already we have studied the three types. So fourth type today we will study. So we will continue with the tetrasporic types of embryosacs. So in that three we have studied already. So fourth one in the tetrasporic embryo sacs, it is Fritillaria type. So today we will study the type called Fritillaria type. So this Fritillaria type of embryo sac, it is found in the plant called Lilium and Fritillaria. So examples you can give for this one is the Lilium bulbiflorum. So one is the Lilium bulbiferum, and another example you can give, that is the plant called Fritillaria. So in different plants you are going to observe this. So one plant you can give as an example, that is Lilium bulbiferum, and there is Fritillaria. So what is the speciality in this tetrasporic embryo sac? We will see, as already you are knowing. So here there will be the formation of megaspore mother cell during the megasporogenesis. So this is the megaspore mother cell which is diploid in nature. It divides meiotically. So this is the first meiotic division during that there will be formation of two nuclei, and there is a second meiotic division. It results in the formation of four nuclei. And these four nuclei which are formed, they will be arranged in the manner that is 1+3 arrangement. So towards the micropylar end there is a movement of one nucleus, and three will gather to the chalazal end. The arrangement is called 1+3 arrangement. So 1+3 arrangement, it is observed in the embryo sac. So we'll find towards the micropylar end there is a movement of one haploid nucleus, and towards the chalazal end there is a movement of three nuclei, and these three nuclei later they fuse. So in the next stage here you can see the fusion of the chalazal three nuclei. So here you will find the fusion of three chalazal nuclei. So here you can see the fused nuclei. So three which are towards the chalazal end, they fuse, and towards the micropylar end there will be the single nucleus. So like this there is a formation of the embryo sac with the four nuclei, and here you will find successive meiotic division. First meiotic division, second meiotic division. After second meiotic division, four nuclei, they will be arranged in the manner called 1+3 arrangement, and in this the micropylar it remains separate, and towards the chalazal end three nuclei which are moving, they are going to fuse. So that is the speciality what you are observing here in the Fritillaria during first meiotic and second meiotic division. Then there will be the next stage. Here you will find next to this there are two mitotic divisions. So you will find first mitotic division. So next stage I am drawing here. So these are two meiotic divisions. After successive two meiotic divisions, the fusion of chalazal nuclei occurs. Then it enters the first mitotic division. And here already you are seeing one nucleus towards the micropylar, and it divides into two nuclei. Similarly, towards the chalazal end, there is a division of fused three nuclei. So you will find the fused nuclei. They divide. So this is a triploid condition. So you'll find the division of fused nucleus. So here you can see the micropylar end with two nuclei, and towards the chalazal end two fused nuclei. So in each you'll find three nuclei, that is the triploid condition. So this is the division of triploid cell, and here you can see two triploids. Then there is occurrence of second mitotic division. So after second mitotic division, you can see the cell or the embryo sac. Here towards the micropylar end, you will find two nuclei become four nuclei, which are haploid in nature. Towards the chalazal end, triploid nuclei which are there, they divide again. So illi two ide, illi four agutte. Triploid structures, they are four in number. So you can see the triploid nuclei which are fused. So this is after the second meiotic division. Then there is a formation of the embryo sac. How they will get arranged themselves, we will see through the diagram. So here at the micropylar end, out of four nuclei, three will form the egg apparatus. So you will find the formation of egg apparatus with the haploid set of chromosome. So centrally located egg you will see, and these two are the synergids. These synergids together form the egg, the egg apparatus. And one of the nucleus from micropylar end, it moves to the center, or it may remain here attached to the egg apparatus. Then these structures which are towards the chalazal end, triploid in nature, they will be forming antipodals. So you'll find the three antipodals, and these antipodals are triploid in nature. So what is the nature of these chalazal structures? They are antipodals with the nature triploid. And here one of the polar chalazal cell, it moves to the center, and here it attaches to the micropylar end nucleus, which gets separated from the four nuclei. And here you can see the fusion of this triploid cell which is coming from the chalazal gland. Now it becomes tetraploid. So this forms the secondary nucleus. This secondary nucleus, it becomes tetraploid. How it becomes tetraploid? One polar nucleus which is haploid fuses with the chalazal triploid structure. So 1 plus 3, it becomes 4. So the nature of secondary nucleus is tetraploid nature. After the fertilization, secondary nucleus becomes the pentaploid. So pentaploid andre one haploid male gamete fuse aagi idra jothege yenagutte later it will be pentaploid. So you will find the formation of embryo sac with how many nuclei. So here the total number of nuclei, they are going to differ. Why? Because here triple fusion is there, so triploid structures are there, but the number of cells, they remain 7 here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So it is 7 celled structure, but total number of nuclei, when you see, they are 16 in number, but they are going to fuse here, so that it is looking like a 8 nucleated embryo sac. 7 celled, 8 nucleated embryo sac. So in the Fritillaria type, you will find the examples Lilium and Fritillaria. Here megaspore mother cell divides mitotically 2 times. So first meiotic division, second meiotic division, arrangement is 1 plus 3, and 3 nuclei at the chalazal end, they fuse to form single cell. And in the next phases, there is occurrence of 2 mitotic successive divisions. This is first mitotic division. So the nucleus which is towards the micropylar end, it divides to form 2 nuclei. Towards the chalazal end, fused nucleus cell, it will be dividing to form 2 triploid cells. Then during second mitotic division, the micropylar 2 nuclei further divide by the division which is called mitotic division. 4 nuclei you can see towards the chalazal end, fused 2 nuclei having cells, they are become 4 at the chalazal end, and they will get arranged in the embryo sac. Towards the primary, that is the micropylar end, you will find the egg apparatus formation. All these are haploids in nature. So egg cell you can see, synergids. Then the cell which is moving towards the center, it will remain near to the egg cell. And here in the last stage, you will find the movement of chalazal cell to the center, where the formation of secondary nucleus you can see. So micropylar end cell, it is with the haploid nature, and the cell which comes towards the central part, it will be having the triploid nature. So second nucleus becomes a tetraploid, and antipodals are always triploid in case of the Fritillaria. So this is the mature embryo sac with the nature called Fritillaria type. It was observed in the plant for the first time, that is called Fritillaria. The name of the tetrasporic embryo sac itself is a Fritillaria type. So here there is a involvement of all the 4 megaspore nuclei, so that the embryo sac we call it as a tetrasporic embryo sac. Next we will study the another type of embryo sac in the next class, that is the type called Plumbagella type. So we will study that in the next class. Thank you.